formed from snow accumulated over millennia that have compacted and hardened to ice. Glaciers are one of nature's great marvels. Essential for biodiversity and the climate, they also represent an immense freshwater resource. Now seriously threatened by a rapidly warming climate, they are the subject of study of many scientists from around the world, and especially in Switzerland, where the Alps are full of these ice giants.
Nowadays, glaciers are impacted a lot by the climate change, so they are evolving very, very quickly. So it's important to know how they move in time and how they react to the climate change in order to predict their melting.
Two PhD researchers from the University of Lausanne are studying different glaciers across Switzerland. One of them is the Zanflorange Glacier at the intersection between three Swiss cantons in the Glacier 3000 resort.
A very concrete application of our work is to predict and prevent a glacier outburst. So what is glacier outburst? So sometimes inside the glacier you have an internal lake that forms because of the fast melting. And when this mass of water is too heavy for the glacier, it cracks and the whole water just goes into the valley.
These catastrophic events regularly claim many lives, especially in the Himalayas where populations are concentrated in the glacial valleys. To better predict glacial outbursts, the scientists study the internal structure of the glaciers using radar pulse imagery. This equipment previously required helicopter flights, but here the researchers have adapted the radar to be fixed onto a drone.
Compared to helicopter-based surveys, drone is a lot more efficient. You can have a really better quality of data because you can fly very close to the ground and also monitor the location of the trajectory very, very precisely with the drone.
The drone is equipped with a ground-penetrating radar. This subsurface imaging system can effectively create a 3D model of the glacier.
A ground-penetrating radar is a geophysical method that uses radar to image the subsurface of the Earth, and in our case, glacier. So the idea is that the radar emits an electromagnetic wave that propagates into the glacier, and when these waves encounter an interface between two middle, so for instance, ice to rock, or ice to water, or ice to air, a part of the wave is reflected. So basically, the data that we get is the time of propagation between the transmission and the reception. The main application of it is that, for example, if you know the time of propagation and also the speed of propagation of the electromagnetic wave in the middle you are studying, so ice forest, then you can deduct the distance between the emission and the interface. So for example, the thickness of the ice in our case, if you consider the interface between the ice and the rock. With some simple interpolation algorithm, you can build a 3D model of the glacier beneath the surface and know, of course, the thickness of the ice everywhere, but also where the locations of the water channels on the air cavity, for example.
I can see how the channels evolve over time, and I can see how they change between the seasons. So does the location of them or the size of them change between summer and winter, and also how it changes between different years. So do the channels always develop in the same places, or is it different from year to year? As you know, the glaciers are an important water supply for our society, and in the background of global warming, we all know that the glaciers will decrease and finally disappear, and of course this impacts our water supply, and if we better understand where the meltwater goes, we can take better measures to adapt to this change.
The project carried out by the researchers from the University of Lausanne will ultimately reveal the secret depths of these icy landscapes. It will help to minimize the consequences that their accelerated decline has on biodiversity and on our society.